In this episode, I'm going to walk you through setting up hotkeys and cool usage for them in OBS Studio. Fiddling with the mouse to change things during your live stream is not very polished or professional. Speed things up with your streaming process. TunnelBear is the fast and easy VPN service that keeps your data safe and secure behind a bear. Sign up for your 7-day free trial and learn more via the link in the video description. I'm Apples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos linked in the playlist in the video description. Check that before asking questions, check the introduction video if you get lost, and let's jump in. In OBS Studio, you can set hotkeys for just about everything. Let's cover some of the main ones you might want to work with. Click Settings and go to Hotkeys. Here, you can set hotkeys to start and stop streaming, start and stop recording, enable studio mode, switch scenes, and enable or disable sources. It's pretty complex. This is why some streamers use an advanced macro keypad like the Elgato Stream Deck to manage their scene switching and such. There are more videos about this in the course playlist in the video description. To set a hotkey for a specific action, click in the empty box and then use the command you wish to map. For example, Alt F12 for start recording. If you want to make it a toggle so that the same keybind does both start and stop recording, simply apply the same keybind to both listings. You can also apply multiple keybindings to the same command with the plus sign. You can remove extra keybindings with the minus button. You can clear keybindings from a command with the clear button. If you have set a keybind and accidentally replaced it, you can hit the revert button to change it back. Below the main control set, you have your scene controls. The scenes are listed on the left along with keybind options to show and hide individual sources and switch to the scenes. Again, if you want to toggle some showing and hiding specific sources like a webcam or overlay, for example, just set the same keybind for both show and hide. Setting up hotkeys to switch between scenes you use regularly can make your streams much more efficient and keep you from having to switch windows during a live stream. Way down below these hotkeys, you have keybinds for muting and unmuting audio sources and enabling push to mute or push to talk on a microphone. Other types of sources can have options for hotkeys as well. For example, Game Capture Source will have a hotkey option for recapturing the current foreground window instead of the previously selected window and to deactivate the capture entirely. Set some hotkeys. Make a list of them near your keyboard if you need to. Optimizing your scene switching can make a world of difference for your stream. I hope this episode of my OBS tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, drop kick that like button and subscribe for more awesome tech videos. If you like game streaming, come follow me over on Twitch and drop a message in chat. Until next time, I'm Apples Vox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.